The three reservoir problem is a classic hydraulics problem that appears in nearly every textbook on civil engineering hydraulics. It also frequently appears on both of the licensing examinations to become a professional engineer. The problem is typically presented with three sources of water, or three reservoirs, at three different elevations. All three reservoirs are hydraulically connected to a single point, in this case, point D, which resides at a specific elevation. In other words, there is some pressure head at D, which is the result of the hydraulic grade line from or to each of these reservoirs. Why on earth would someone ever install a system that has three different sources of water supplying three different amounts of energy to the system is beyond me. Such a situation is difficult to operate and maintain, and it doesn't really matter because these kinds of problems are so popular that even though they do not represent the typical reality we deal with as practicing engineers, they are popular with exam writers. Approaching the three reservoir problem, we use conservation of mass and apply this to point D. In other words, the summation of the flow rates coming into or flowing out of point D must sum to zero. We also use conservation of energy. Applying conservation of energy here means that the elevation of reservoir A minus the head loss in pipe 1, or the elevation of reservoir B minus the head loss in pipe 2, or the elevation of reservoir C plus the head loss in pipe 3 should all be equal to the elevation plus the pressure head at point D. A typical analysis scenario usually involves, given all of the pipe data, the diameters, lengths, and roughness of the pipelines, as well as giving the elevations of the reservoirs in pump D, the task would be to find the flow rates from reservoir A, B, and C, as well as the pressure head gradient at point D. The approach to this particular problem is to pick a value for the pressure head at point D such that the summation of the flow into or out of point D is zero. In other words, once you have a guess for the pressure at D, then you can solve for the head losses getting to or from D for each of the water sources. Once you know the head loss, then you can use Darcy-Weisbach or Hazen-Williams to calculate the flow rate. In other words, the solution is found through iteration. Therefore, to help speed up the iteration, it is best to calculate the pipe characteristics, in other words, the R term, from the pipes in parallel presentation in advance. Another scenario is the flow rate from one of the reservoirs is known, along with the pipe data and elevations as well. Here the task would be to find the flow rate to or from either of the other reservoirs. Because you are given one flow rate, you can find the pressure head at D. Once you know the pressure head at D, then you can solve for the head loss to or from the other source in question. Knowing the head loss from the source to D will allow you to calculate the flow rate, and then you are done. No iteration necessary. There are, of course, other scenarios, but the key to approaching these problems is understanding conservation of mass, in other words, the summation of flows at D is zero, and conservation of energy dictates that the head loss from each reservoir to D results in the same pressure gradient at point D. The rest is just algebra.